Do we need arc fault protection or nah? So, for those of you in the Stone Age that don't know what arc fault protection is, AFCI, arc fault circuit interrupter protection. It is a way to interrupt a circuit if there is a arc fault. So what is an arc fault? There's two different kinds of arc faults. There's series arcs and there's parallel arcs. So a series arc is if you have a wire and that wire breaks. Now in series in the circuit, you have a arcing point. And there's certain characteristics of this arcing that they've been able to figure out an algorithm and stuff a circuit board inside of a breaker, and it can figure out what's happening in a circuit based off of the signature of this behavior. Parallel arc is a little bit different. That's when you have a hot and a neutral. Instead of shorting out to each other, they're arcing between each other. And arcing can create heat, it can cause fires, it can cause electrocution, it can cause a lot of different things. But there's breakers that are smart enough now that can tell whether or not there is a series arc or a parallel arc. And in both cases, it can trip a breaker. So that is what AFCI protection is. AFCI protection comes in the same forms as GFCI protection. So you'll either have a receptacle that says AFCI instead of GFCI on it, or you'll have a breaker in a panel that says AFCI. Sometimes it might say CAFCI or combination AFCI. Combination AFCI means that it does series and parallel arcs, which all breakers should do now. Don't get that twisted with dual function breakers. Just because it says combination does not mean it's dual function. Dual function is where there is GFCI protection and AFCI protection in the same breaker. So a dual function breaker is even like more on steroids, essentially, because it'll protect if there's ground faults or both series and parallel arc faults. Now, what does code actually say about it? Where are we required to put AFCI devices in? This is really interesting because with GFCIs, we're specifically talking about receptacles where we plug a receptacle in, somebody could be standing in water. So it's to protect people, personnel. There's places where equipment has to be protected too. You might have this massive switchgear, like 2000 amp switchgear. And when you energize that, you don't want a ground fault. If there's a ground fault, you could send fireballs through a room. So you have to actually have GFCI protection on some equipment as well to protect that equipment. But most of the time we're talking GFCIs, you know, in for receptacles, we're talking about just like personnel protection. So when we talk about GFCIs, in the last video I did, I mentioned that it's receptacles only. There's one instance in which they do mention lighting outlets in crawl spaces. Specifically, that's the only place, but other than that, it's for specifically receptacles. So with arc fault protection, what does it say? It's a little bit different than that. So we're in 210.12, arc fault circuit interrupter protection. Arc fault circuit interrupter protection shall be installed in accordance with 210.12b through e by any of the means described in 210.12a1 through a6. The AFCI shall be listed and installed in a readily accessible location. Readily accessible meaning you don't have to like move anything, climb up on ladders to like uncover this receptacle or gain access to it. It's readily accessible, meaning like easily just right there. Now in part A, it shows all of the different means of protection. So it lists the different types. I'm not gonna read all of these, but number one, a listed combination type AFCI installed to provide protection of the entire branch circuit. So like a breaker style that protects the entire circuit. A listed branch or feeder type AFCI installed at the origin of the branch circuit in combination with a listed outlet branch circuit type AFCI. So there are actual outlets that go in your wall that can provide AFCI protection. So from the first point through the rest of the circuit, you're protecting it. So there's a bunch of different like ways in which you can do this, and depending on what kind of conduit you're running conductors in, stuff like that, you might be able to get away with doing it one of these different ways in A1 through 6. But B is what I wanted to talk about. B is the dwelling units section of this. So there's basically anything that's habitable. Is it habitable or is it habitable? In B, it talks about specifically with dwelling units. C talks about dormitory units, and D talks about other occupancies. So it's still all things where people are gonna be sleeping in, essentially, even though they're talking about other occupancies. So in dwelling units, this is what most people are watching for right now. So we're gonna talk about just normal dwelling units. It says all 120 volt single phase, 10, 15, and 20 amp branch circuits. Not receptacles, not lights, not equipment, not switches, the entire circuit. So all 10, 15, and 20 amp branch circuits, 120 volt, that are supplying outlets or devices installed in the following locations shall be protected by any of the means described in 210.12 A1 through A6, which we were just talking about. It's specifically the location that they care about, making sure that anything in that area, whether it's a hardwired appliance, whether it's a receptacle, whether it's a switch and a light, lighting outlet, doesn't matter. It's the entire branch circuit in these areas. Kitchens, everything in a kitchen, expanded to whatever a kitchen means to you. Again, we had the GFCI language changed to say kitchens, and then it says areas with sinks and permanent provisions for food preparation, beverage preparation, or cooking. They kind of like split that up. So this might allow them a little bit of leeway to like get away with not having to do some of the part that you might not consider a kitchen, but it's kind of a prep cooking area. But the actual kitchen, which on the plan just says kitchen on it, you know what I mean? Like, they probably should have changed this as well. Whatever you think a kitchen is, actually really, whatever your inspector thinks a kitchen is, because ultimately they're gonna be the ones giving you the thumbs up or the thumbs down. So anything in a kitchen. Family rooms, so family rooms, you can consider that a place where family spends time, I suppose. It's like a living room, but they're gonna specifically say living rooms. Family room, dining room, living rooms, those could all be the same room. Typically dining room has a table and chairs, but mine doesn't. Mine has a drum set and a weight bench. So it's a dining room nonetheless. Living rooms, parlors, libraries, dens. Then we've got bedrooms, all bedrooms, sunrooms, recreation rooms. So I mean, that could be like a weight room or something like that in the house. Closets, hallways, laundry areas, and my favorite of them all, similar areas. Why not just say every room in the house? Why? All 120 volt single phase, 10, 15 amp, 20 amp branch circuit supplying the entire house. Every circuit in the entire house. But no. No, where are the no's? The no's are bathrooms. There's nothing about bathrooms on here. There's nothing about garages on here. I get there's some things in the garage that you might plug in that, you know, you don't want tripping. So like they kind of give leeway on that because there's some manufacturers that have nuisance tripping. If you plug their stuff in, it constantly trips breakers. I get that. Outdoors is also another thing that's not listed. So anything is basically only indoors and not bathrooms and garages. Everything else needs to be arc fault protected. And I see that changing in the coming years. I actually think in the not so distant future, panels are gonna be a lot smarter and they're gonna be able to detect ground faults and arc faults, and they're gonna be able to give you a lot more diagnostics. So I can kind of see in the future just it expanding to every circuit needs to be GFCI protected and AFCI protected, and manufacturers are gonna have to start manufacturing their equipment to make sure that it can be on those circuits, that it can, it's not gonna interfere with the running of a breaker because it's just doing weird stuff. I could see that happening. So that's pretty much it for the dwelling unit. So it's basically everything in your house except for bathrooms and garages. The exception, AFCI protection shall not be required for individual branch circuits supplying a fire alarm system installed in accordance with 760.41B or 760.121B. The branch circuit shall be installed in a metal raceway, metal auxiliary gutter, steel armored cable, or type MC or type AC cable, meeting if the applicable requirements of 250.118 with metal boxes, conduit bodies, and enclosures. Exception number two, AFCI protection shall not be required for the individual branch circuit supplying an outlet for arc welding equipment in a dwelling until January 1st of 2025. A breaker detects arcs. An arc fault breaker. An arc welder is an arc throwing machine. How are they gonna have arc fault breakers that don't trip when you have an arcing welder in 2025? By 2025. It senses arcs. That's its whole purpose. So how are you gonna make, you're gonna change the way, the nature of welders, or are you going to make breakers? Oh God, I can't wait to see this one. All right, so that's it. Then we've got dormitory units. If you want to go into that and look, it's pretty much the same thing. Just there's a lot less stuff in dormitory units, so they don't, it's kind of like not as expanded of a list. All other occupancies covers guest rooms of hotels and motels and stuff like that. So it's still places people are going to be like being habitable. All right, then we've got E, which is important to cover too. Branch circuit wiring extensions, modifications, or replacements. If you take out a panel, do you really have to make sure all of the arc fault breakers are put in? What it says is if you're extending the circuits, then you do, but if you're just directly changing a panel out, probably not. But here in Austin, kind of depends on the inspector, it depends on which city around the town that you're actually working in, whether or not they want you to do it. Sometimes they'll say, we don't care, you changed out a service, so we want you to upgrade every single one of the breakers and put all arc faults in. It's like, well, we didn't extend any circuits, we didn't add any new wire. And they're like, we don't care, add arc faults everywhere. This is what code specifically says. It says if branch circuit wiring for any of the areas specified in 210.12 B, C, or D is modified, replaced, or extended, the branch circuit shall be protected by one of the following. By any of those means in 210.12 A, by a listed outlet branch circuit type AFCI located at the first receptacle outlet of the existing branch circuit. And then the exception to it says AFCI protection shall not be required where the extension of the existing branch circuit conductors is not more than 6 feet and does not include any additional outlets or devices other than splicing devices. This measurement shall not include the conductors inside of an enclosure, cabinet, or junction box. So there you go. If you're not extending the circuit, then this book says that you don't have to worry about making sure that it's upgraded to AFCI protection. But I would check with your inspectors on that first. So if you want to watch a little bit more about ground fault circuit interrupter protection, GFCI protection, click this video here. I did a very similar thing where I go through the code and talk about it in depth. And if you want to learn more about ground fault, arc fault, and dual function, I have a video right here. Love you crazy people. See you in the next one.